All right, welcome back, everybody. We are live here in Burbank for week number 3 of the Overwatch TESPA Collegiate Series. So we still have 230 teams from across the nation competing for their share at over $100,000 in scholarship prizing. I'm James Jamerson Lee, and joining me once again on the casting desk is Seamus Seamus Anderson. Seamus, we are in week number 3. We're starting to see teams starting to stand out.
Absolutely, and we're going to be looking at the North and the East region today. And Jamerson, of course, I am from the Virginia area. We have a couple of Virginian schools playing today. I'm really excited about that.
Yeah, we saw a lot of great Northern and Eastern teams last weekend, and I'm really excited to see who actually, you know, gets that 3-0 record this week.
Right, since we are in week 3, if a team wins this game today, most of these teams are already 2-0 with 2-0 records. They're going to make it guaranteed into the playoffs.
Yeah, so like you said, we are starting off on the Northern region today. The regions are broken down to the North, the South, the West, and the East. It is going to be 5 weeks of group play. Now, teams that have a 3-0 record or better will move on to the regional playoffs.
And in the regional playoffs, it's a single elimination bracket. It and you want to make it to the end of the playoffs to get into that regional championship.
Yeah, and in the regional championships, that's where, you know, things are really on the line. The top two teams will be making the scholarship money, but only one will be walking away to our live finals.
At the live finals, we'll see the top team out of each region compete for the remainder of that over $100,000 scholarship prize.
Yeah, so a lot on the line. And we saw, actually, it's not just the scholarship money. It's also the pride. Mm-hmm. In that matchup yesterday, UCB versus Arizona State University, there was a real big rivalry. You know, they were both teams that competed very well in Heroes of the Dorm, and now they're trying to recreate that success here in Overwatch.
And also there are rivalries based on location. We've seen teams from two universities from Boston clash. We're going to see teams from Toronto later tonight. Mm-hmm. So besides that scholarship, you know, the fierce rivalries in competitive sports, we're seeing that translate over to esports as well with Overwatch.
Yeah. And so, yeah, we talked about the Western and the Southern regions and the Eastern. So let's go ahead and take a look at our schedule for today. So we are going to be starting off on, I believe this is the Eastern region. Mm-hmm. It's going to be Virginia Commonwealth University facing off against Concordia University Montreal for our first match. Our second match is going to be George Mason facing off against Albany. And then to round out our match of the evening, is going to be UOIT facing off against Toronto. Actually, we've also got a bonus match. It's going to be Iowa versus University of Minnesota and Morris also for our fourth match of the evening, if we get to that.
Yeah, so we have a little bit of extra time based on the schedule, so we're probably going to have more games, potentially 4 games a night now, which would be really cool to see.
Yeah, and so we are in week number 3. A lot of these teams are currently sitting at 2-0. If we take a look at the Eastern region, looks like, you know, your home state of Virginia represented pretty well. VCU, that's Virginia Commonwealth University, already off to a great start, 2-0, on the cusp of, you know, securing their spot in the regional playoffs. West Virginia also. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we saw about 3 teams yesterday securing their spot.
And on there too, we see VCU and Concordia University of Montreal. So the two teams that we're going to see in this first match. Week 2 has passed, and for this third week, it's a lot of these teams, their chance at the first chance to guarantee a berth into that playoff bracket.
And yeah, I know a lot of these kids are in the midterms right now, so to get that pressure off of you this week, it's going to be fantastic. But yeah, if we take a look at our lineup, it's going to be VCU versus Concordia University. The lineup for Virginia Commonwealth University is going to be Pixel Bob, Moldy Cereal, Tuna, Kevin, What a Trooper, and Sondero. Got a comp sci major, another information science. There we go. Another comp sci, international relations, and then to round it all out, health.
So Sondero as the health major, if he's letting his teammates eat moldy cereal, I don't know about that.
Well, he might, you know, be able to change his majors if it doesn't work out.
But Tuna's pretty healthy.
Tuna is healthy. Yeah. It really is. Their opponents for the evening are going to be Concordia University Montreal. Right, we've got Demi, Heaven Winds, Pandorius, Lebic, Saya, and Jehudi. Computation Arts, Comp Science, and another Comp Sci major.
CS majors. Demi is a substitution for one of the players, so I'm curious to see if there are any sort of issues at all. I would expect not, but I want to remind you guys that the heroes you see and the roles that they play, that's their most played hero in competitive. So sometimes, it'll translate to what we see in game here, but obviously it's generally just an indicator of what they're comfortable with. Most of the meta, most of the strategy we've seen have been 2-2-2, fairly standard stuff.
Yeah, we've seen actually a lot of these players do have a decent hero pool, right? A lot of depth. I mean, we saw some of the DPS players yesterday pull out 5, 6, 7 different heroes over the course of a series. And so transitioning those skills over to another class, not too difficult if they can handle 7 different heroes in these like assault and defense classes.
For Overwatch 2, it's not like there's a formula for what works. And some players were suggesting that they only play maybe 1, 2, 3 heroes max. But we've seen players do exceptionally well playing 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 heroes. So flexing can be a very valuable thing.
Yeah, and we saw actually for our next map, all the matches today are going to be starting off on Hanamura. Mm-hmm. On Hanamura, it was very volatile in the hero compositions that were coming out from both from most of the teams. We saw Pharahs, Reapers, McCrees. There was the
we saw Tracer.
Tracer coming out, Genji. I mean, almost every hero was played, except for probably Torbjörn. No. Someone pulled out a Torbjörn.
I think there are a few heroes that we didn't see.
Yeah.
But for the most part, we saw different strategies on defense. We saw a lot of Maze. Mm-hmm. We saw the occasional Reinhardt as well, double shotguns, just try and control that without the Maywall. We saw aggressive Maze. So you're talking about all the heroes we saw, Pharah, Reaper, Winston, Tracer, try and jump, try and get past the choke point. We just saw people try and use the Maywall to jump over. So this map really allows for a lot of different strategies, and that's what we've seen so far. Now into the map, we'll see what VCU and Concordia can show us.
It is going to be Concordia University starting off on the attacking side here. So let's go ahead and take a look at the defensive setup coming out from VCU. VCU, their spawn's going to unlock now, so it looks like they are going to stick to this in pretty darn standard composition, right? You've got that 2-2-2, Reinhardt, the frontal shield, and then Moldy Serial will be picking up that Zarya, and Tuna is the one playing the Mei. We've got the counterpart McCree, Kevin, right there, helping out, dish out any damage, and then just standard supports Lucio and the Ana.
And VCU's lineup, probably the biggest surprise would be the McCree, but that's really not that big of a of a surprise. You know, sometimes you'll see a Roadhog.
I think
or
it's a good pickup.
I think it's fine. You have mid-range damage. You're going to be able to crowd control in conjunction with the Maywall and the freeze and the charge from Reinhardt. It's going to be a huge amount of CC.
Yeah, we also saw that there were a lot of players actually picking up Pharah yesterday on many different maps. So I think Pharah, you know, really starting to find her place in the meta now, but Of course, McCree is a great counter to that.
Definitely been something that people go to if they want a comfort pick. And with that hit skin here, you're going to deal with it anyway. First Fire Strike is going to land. It's a double shotgun composition with a Mei as well on the offense. Levick coming around the side here. We'll see whether or not they try to just walk through or walk over the defensive wall. As of right now, they don't see the defensive Mei.
Yeah, Montreal is also running that Zenyatta. So Zenyatta, not a pick that we see often. Great choice coming out from Levick there. He's going to go ahead and wall off the line of sight there so they can't wall off the choke point and allow them to get in. But an Earth Shatter coming in from VCU. That's going to be a full team wipe clean coming out from them for the first engagement.
Very, very well done by Pixel Bob. That Fire Strike we saw at the first few seconds of the game meant that he's going to get his ultimate so quickly. And for VCU, they were able to just destroy them in that team fight. Montreal had a decent idea, but sticking in that area, that room where it's close quarters, I don't think that was a good idea. We'll see what they do on the second offense.
Yeah, it was a great counter wall off by Tuna. Once they got in there, they created another choke point at that point and created like this death room for them, right?
And without any strong shielding either, that Earthshatter just destroyed them. So they're grouping up again. Kevin, we see him on the high ground. He needs to be careful not to get picked off. That Discord will drop if he's out of sight for 3 seconds. Ooh, first kill over to Pixel Bob.
Yeah, so they tried that thing again where they try to block off the line of sight from Tuna. But Tuna was playing it much closer to the door, so at that point she just walked up and was able to separate Levick on the side of Montreal, and that's, of course, an easy cleanup as we've seen before.
Part of what we've seen with Mei aggressively is you go on the high ground, you can just jump over their wall with a wall of your own, but that's not really what Concordia University of Montreal have done so far. They're just going to try and continuously battle this. The shield is low on both Reinhardts. Moldy Serial really close. Getting 100% charge, and he has his Graviton too, so he can do so much damage.
And yeah, so here comes the wall, but that's going to be a great target for that Graviton Surge. Most of the members of Montreal caught in it. Now here's the Transcendence, but Transcendence cannot heal you through the burst as Kevin picks up a double kill off of his first Deadeye, and now he's on the hunt, picks up a triple, getting the stun grenade off onto Heaven Winds, and still 1v1 against Levick, and whoo, Levick was so close to getting, I think, the first frag on this side of Montreal. Montreal haven't gotten a frag yet.
It's been pretty tough for Montreal. They wanted to make it through the choke point again with the wall, but the thing is, the Graviton Surge just kept them in the same area, and afterwards, VCU bodied them. Kevin had a really good two-man flashbang, found the first kill, and then was able to kill the Mei with the help of his allies. And here comes Jehud. He lands the hook.
Yeah, he lands the hook, but there is the Zarya barrier there to keep him alive. And
oh,
now
no.
Here comes the wall off that does separate the team, but no follow-up frags quite yet coming out from VCU. So the team fight getting reset here, and Lepic has the high ground. He's getting some nice right clicks off, but Kevin's the one that gets the initial frag. And here we go, three man Earthshatter coming out, but in the back line, Heaven wins with the Death Blossom, picks up a double kill, and now he's getting hunted down. This might be another kill. No, it's gonna be Kevin that comes in with the shot, the headshot to take out Heaven wins. Another great hold coming up from VCU.
And another great Earthshatter. Oh, the Lucio from the offense has been delayed for so long. Say, ah, that's just gonna burn a few seconds. And for Montreal, they don't have seconds to spare. With only 40 seconds remaining, it's probably gonna be their last grouped up 6v6 team fight, and the only ultimate they're close to, or have, I should say, right now, is the Mei ultimate. They're close to Transcendence, they're close to Roadhog ultimate as well. Gonna get a sound barrier from Lucio in a few moments, but they really need to play this correctly, Jamerson.
All right, so here comes the wall off. That's gonna allow them to push forward, but this Mei is getting hunted down by Moldacirio. Here is the Transcendence, but now the Graviton Surge coming out on the side of VCU.
No.
Three kills going over so quickly, and Heaven Winds has switched off to this Genji, but I don't think he's gonna be long for this world as the rest of his team has already gotten cleaned up. 5 seconds left, and I think VCU might have gotten this hold.
VCU with such a dominant defense. There were maybe 3, 4, 5 frags that round in favor of Concordia, whereas VCU was clearing every single time. The ultimate coordination was fantastic. The individual ultimates were very well used as well. And for VCU now to take this map, to take Hanamura, they simply need to push to this first point.
Oh yeah, VCU were doing a great job of cycling their tanks ultimates, right? They weren't stacking the Earth Shatter on top of the Graviton. They were being very patient and seeing how many frags they can get off of one before they committed the next one. They didn't have to because the follow-up damage was right there. As soon as an Earth Shatter came in, so did the rest of the damage. As soon as Graviton Surge came in, even through the Transcendence, the damage was coming through.
So we'll see now what exactly VCU has planned. Probably the only criticism I would have is a few moments of lack of coordination. Like, there was one Ana ult, I think, that was walled off pretty well by the offense, and they didn't get much value out of it. But even then, during that time, it was still a situation where VCU, they didn't get value out of the ultimate, but half of the enemy team was trapped behind a wall. Half the enemy team was caught between in this 3v6 fight. So VCU, with that strong of a showing, Jamerson, I would suspect their offense is strong as well. Tuna is currently sitting on that Torbjorn. That would be an interesting pick. I think this Genji is probably much more likely, but we'll see what he does.
Yeah, I like the Genji a lot more, to say the least.
I would like probably anything more than the offensive Torbjorn, the Hanamura.
Now, what's interesting here is that Concordia University, they're not going for a Mei themselves. Mm-hmm. They saw how effective it was. They had a Mei player in Lepic, but instead they want to put Lepic on this hit scan, McCree, as Heaven Winds will be picking up that Reaper instead.
We'll see how this plays out. It's a lot of upfront damage. It's a lot of damage at close range. For VCU, if they get caught up at the choke point and don't really run their way through or find a quick pick, it might be a situation where they're taking too much damage. But for now, Tuna is going to try and flank.
Oh, so Lebic not able to immediately flashbang him, but now Tuna is doing a good job. This is what you want to do as Genji, right? Mm-hmm. Just draw back the defense and make sure that your team can actually push forward without too much resistance. So now they have made it through the choke point, and so they are pushing forward. Tuna still in the back lines here, drawing so much attention, but he does finally get flashbanged and taken out by Lebic. So now it's going to be 6v5. Lebic does drop low. The Biotic Nade keeping him down. Pixel Bob finds a kill onto Heaven's Wind, and now it's a 2-for-2 trade.
It's a 4v4 on the point right now, and the offense is going to make it back there faster. More kills for VCU. Jehudi on the Roadhog, one of the last remaining members, gets taken down, and the Genji plays. Tuna did eventually get eaten, but he was able to stall and stop the aggression from Concordia University long enough for his team to get there, win the team fight, take the point, and win the match.
All right, so yeah, VCU with a very great performance here on Hanamura. And that's kind of just the nature of Hanamura, right? The defense can really hold out if you start off with that main, like, your walls are impeccable. And they were doing a great job on the side of VCU. The counter walls, even though Concordia University were trying to break the line of sight with their own May, it just wasn't as executed as well as it could have been. But still, I like the idea. I like that they went for it.
So let's take a look at the play of the game. This is when we saw earlier VCU have a perfect Earth Shatter and then just the completely 6-for-0 team fight completely wiped them there with a great, great Earth Shatter by Pixel Bob and the follow-up from the Zarya.
Yeah, and you got to really be worried about a Reinhardt. I mean, if you see 2-3 people getting hit by that Fire Strike
early on, yeah,
very early on out the gates, you got to know that he's about 30% there. And then when they funneled into that area, he was getting some swings off, and he hit about 3 or 4 people at the same time.
Right. The issue is, you know, for Montreal, had they maybe run up the stairs or run out the right side, they would have been okay. But they tried to fight in close range. And normally when you have 2 shotgun heroes, that's not a bad idea. But when you're funneled in, you don't have that much strong shielding. And the enemy Reinhardt was that close to ulti already. It's a recipe for disaster.
And then, you know, I mean, their backs were against the wall. Literally. Their ice wall. They were, you know, cats in a corner, right, being poked at. So they had to fight. But unfortunately, that Reinhardt Earth Shattered. That was probably one of the quickest I've ever seen, because that was maybe 20, 30 seconds into the game.
That was very early into the game. So for Concordia University Montreal.
Yeah. So guess what map we're going to be actually going to next?
Oh, I was about to think about it. What map? Lijiang.
It's going to be Lijiang again, ladies and gentlemen. I think that's going to be our third or fourth time. Fourth time?
In a row, yeah.
Yeah, fourth time in a row. So we went from Hanamura straight to Lijiang. So Lijiang, we've talked about this before, a control type map. But it does favor a more scrappier team fight style team.
Right, with the control maps, the king of the hill maps, as a lot of people like to call them, it's about fighting, it's about team execution. It's less about general map strategy or preparing a certain flank or knowing your corners and your angles. It's just about which team can get stuff done better and then win these fights. So if that's the strength of Concordia University of Montreal, they might be thinking, okay, against VCU here, it wasn't a map we practiced on very often. Yeah. Let's just take them to a control map and fight them.
Yeah, and they're all... Most of the control maps are generally the same, right? The geography doesn't change too much or affect the team fights that much differently. So practicing on the King of the Hill maps, that's where you get like the most bang for your buck in scrim hours.
Yeah, and in terms of team fighting, absolutely.
Yeah. And so we'll see if actually we start off on Garden again. Because I believe every time we went to Lijiang, we also started off on Garden.
That would be pretty spooky. That would be very spooky.
Yeah, just in time for the seasons, right?
Exactly. I don't know, though, if Concordia University, I'm curious if they want to take that same strategy we saw them play with the Roadhog Reaper. Oh, my goodness.
Look at that.
I feel like it's not even RNG at this point. But we are on the Garden map.
Are these predetermined starting off in Garden?
So are they going to stick with what they did in that last round? They have the Roadhog Reaper right now, but they have more tanks. That's interesting.
So they are hovering over this 3-2-1 composition. It can work. I mean, Roadhog does a lot of does a lot here. A lot of threats, right? He can pull you off the ledges, and he just generally offers a lot of upfront DPS. But on the side of VCU, they're going for a more standard 2-2-2.
If VCU and Montreal stick with these comps, the Ana for Montreal, Seiya, is going to have to be protected and play very smart. Because you know that Genji, that Winston, they're all going to be jumping for him, and probably that Reaper too. So Ana positioning is very important in these King of the Hill maps to keep her alive to get her ultimate faster.
Yeah, I'm surprised that VCU aren't running an Ana themselves, but Zenyatta does a decent job of healing at range, but not as much healing. Now, taking a look at the teams, neither of them are going to actually confront each other as VCU approach from the bridge and Concordia approach from the white room. But take a look at Demi immediately getting melted. And wow, 2-1 in favor of VCU as Tuna jumps on top of this Roadhog. He wants to get this frag, but no, he's going to fall back. Kevin is the one that gets the kill onto his counterpart. And there we go. Dash resets coming in for Tuna as he picks up the kill onto Pandorius. And great team fight coming out from VCU right now. They just need to clean up this last kill onto Seiya, and that's going to be Tuna.
Kevin on the front line, but Tuna was also so good from mid range. He did over 300 damage to the enemy Zarya, and they were able to pick up that kill in a very clean team fight for VCU and Jameson. They already have 2 ultimates available close to some more. This is going to be rough for Concordia University Montreal.
Yeah, and they are running into the white room right now, and so when they're funneled in like this, they're just prime targets for that Graviton Surge. They're just going to wait this barrier out, and there we go. Immediately, they jump on top of them with the Dragon Blade. We did have the sound barrier coming out on the side of Concordia, and unfortunately, Tuna didn't get the dash resets that he wanted there. But
yeah,
if he had maybe survived another extra second there.
There are fish down there. They're like fish swimming, and he's like, I'm a tuna IRL now. fortunately for him and VCU, that didn't actually end up being that big of an issue. The follow-up damage they had on the Graviton Surge was pretty good. I think he might have just missed the wall climb.
Try to go for the climb?
Yeah, like it was a bit of a blooper, but still, VCU, totally comfortable.
I mean, there were some changes to Genji, right? You don't get, like, the extra jump after the wall or double jump wall jump.
Yeah.
Right? Oh, you don't get that anymore. Yeah, so now we're seeing Lebix switching off to that Pharah. So we've seen Pharah actually come into real prominence over the last few weeks. But nice boop coming out there. It's going to get the kill onto Jehudi. And here's the Death Blossom on the side of Concordia University. But most of it is blocked by a great timed sound barrier. Now, counter Death Blossom coming out. Kevin picking up a double kill off of that, and now he's on the hunt. It's going to be Wada Troopa that cleans that up, but a great team fight for VCU, and already 82% on the board.
Everything going well for VCU. We saw the ultimate there from Kevin, the team fight. So much damage coming out of there that Concordia University Montreal just really couldn't contest. And even Sondero getting hit off by the Fire Blast, he was able to wall climb and make it back. So that wall ride really working out for him. Now Tuna with the Dragon Blade. They're not even going to get to the point, I think, in time, Jamerson.
Yeah, there's a Primal Rage here that's keeping them back. It's going to be Pixel Bob that gets the first kill onto Dimi, but now this Graviton Surge should seal the deal, and that's going to be VCU taking a dominant first point here.
Wow.
Yeah. They looked solid.
That was no questions asked. VCU just had a great map, and for CM from Montreal here, it's starting to be a bit of a rough series because of that earlier game and now this first map. We'll see if they can swap up their strats and do a little bit better here. I mean, the Pharah swap, I like swapping to something. When things aren't going well, even if you think you're good on them, sometimes it's better to just swap to what you're comfortable with, even if it's off meta, or something entirely just to change the pace of the game. We'll see if they can do that, though, on this night market section.
Yeah, but VCU already answering that Pharah pick. They're actually picking up the McCree on Kevin. So now we are pushing forward. We are on Night Market, like you said. But we're going to see if Tuna can get some decent poke off here. Yeah. Reinhardt's probably going to block most of that damage. Ooh. Pixel Bob jumps on in first. And that's going to allow them to pick up that first frag onto Jehudi. Actually, how the first map started off here on Lijiang Tower, it was the Lucio player, Sundaro, that got the kill onto Jehudi immediately off. But now here we go. As we do push forward, Kevin, nice flashbang, gets the headshot onto Pantorius, and now Wada Trooper answering himself. Gonna get the kill onto Heaven Winds, and now Sundaro again coming up for his team, getting the kill onto Say-Ah. And now that was an easy team fight for VCU.
Mispositioning there. You gotta keep your Lucios, your supports behind the shield. Unfortunately for Montreal now, the coordination really isn't working out. The flanking DPS, flanking offense heroes too, weren't able to find anything on their own. And I really want to shout out VCU's fantastic coordination on top of Pixel Bob. He's been supported so well, and that's how he finds early frags.
Yeah, and he's also got his Primal Rage, so even if he jumped in there, he would have been perfectly fine. But now here's the Graviton Surge.
Man.
Tuna getting the reset. That's a triple kill for himself.
Jeez.
Yeah, great job coming out from him. There we go. Moldy Cereal will help him clean up another one. And Kevin coming in. Great team play coming out from VCU. And when they you know, sense the blood in the water, they immediately dive.
Tuna, man. Carnivorous fish. Sometimes you slice tuna, sometimes tuna slices you. That's at least what we're seeing from this Genji right now. For VCU, 50% on the scoreboard, 4 ultimates to work with. Concordia University Montreal, they have 2.
Yeah, Tuna's got his Dragon Blade at the ready.
Oh my goodness.
A nice Primal Rage coming out from Pixel Bob. That's a double knockoff from him. So I imagine he's going to get the Environmental Kills medal there. Now we do have Heaven Winds bringing it back, though. A great Death Blossom picks up a triple kill for them. But still, they're on the back foot as the Dragon Blade comes on in from Tuna. And he is slashing them down. Gets the kill onto Pandorius. We have the sound barrier in this 2v2 fight right now. And it's, Tuna against the world. But now, Sundaro is going to have to back off as Tuna does finally get cleaned up by Heaven Winds. And now, Concordia University, with a little bit of room to work here, can breathe a slight sigh of relief.
Still pretty scary, though. when we saw that Winston, it was actually still 3v3 on the fight, and the Dragon Blade was thankfully dealt with for Montreal. Now they're going to be able to get some percentage up. Let's see if they hold the point. Earthshatter is nearly available.
Yeah, right now, Demi just waiting for the Earthshatter. He's going to wait for this Deadeye, and there we go. Levitt gets the kill onto Wada Trooper with that Deadeye, and still Demi being patient with this Earthshatter, waiting for them to push forward. Doesn't have much left in his barrier, so I'm thinking he might be going forward with it soon. No, they know they have the advantage. They don't need to force anything here. They're building good time here. Here comes the Graviton Surge with the Sound Bearer answered on the side of Concordia University. And now they're trying to engage, but Pandora is starting this team fight off, getting the kill onto Pixel Bob. And now they are pushing forward. That was also the Nano Boost used by Seiya, but they weren't able to get much off of it as VCU just backed away.
Patient play working out there for Concordia. Honestly, I wasn't sure whether or not the Earthshatter was going to be used, but eventually he used it, but they waited for the Graviton Surge from the enemy team. They had a Sound Bearer to answer that and were able to boost and win the team fight afterwards. That being said, though, since they used so many ultimates, they're going to be at a disadvantage now, whereas VCU is very close to having all six, so this next team fight might be difficult.
Yeah, so 80% to 75% as another Graviton Surge comes out on the side of Montreal, on the side of VCU, excuse me, and now Tuna is following that up with that Dragon Blade. He only gets the one kill, but the rest of his team putting in work, and now that's going to be a full team wipe for VCU, 81%. Concordia is still going to have an opportunity to attack, though.
They have some time to make it back here. They'll have a Zarya ultimate. Pandorius is close to the Sound Barrier, but I don't think they're going to be able to get there consistently with all six fast enough. They have to contest as soon as they possibly can. 5 seconds remaining. Here they go.
Here they go. Sound Barrier popped, and now they are pushing forward. Transcendence answered by VCU a little early, but it might have just kept them alive. Pixel Bob is going to find the first frag, and now with that Graviton Surge, it looks like VCU might finish off this point against Concordia Montreal. There we go. Kevin gets that last frag onto Jehudi, and that's going to be VCU leading 2-0 here on Lijiang Towers.
VCU able to control the point well enough. Montreal was trying to get in there as well as they could, but unfortunately for them, they really weren't able to compose themselves. I mean, they had to trickle in. They just didn't have the time remaining. Maybe with 5-10 seconds longer, they could have waited a little bit, gone in with a coordinated Graviton Surge, but unfortunately for them, it's going to be another map over to VCU and sitting on set point now.
Yeah, VCU on one point away from securing their third win and securing their spot in the regional playoffs. So Concordia University have to make the ultimate run back here. They need to get three points in a row and then another map because they are currently down 1-0 against VCU. So very tough at this point.
We have a D.Va now from Demi. That's interesting. See whether or not it can negate any sort of Reaper play from Kevin or what the use is. Pixel Bob, they're going so aggressive. VCU, this is part of their success is how aggressive they played, and they give the opponents no time to respond.
Yeah, they work around Pixel Bob really well, like you said earlier. You know, he has his his bubble, but there we go. Levic finding the first frag onto Tuno, so that's the DPS down. That's going to afford them a lot of room. Should be able to force them back as Kevin gets taken out by Seiya. Seiya landing two nice shots onto him to clean them up. Look at Jehudi doing a great job of keeping his supports alive. Now, Pixel Bob has jumped onto the back line, but the Biotic Nade will keep the Ana alive for now, but Moldy Serial coming in. Graviton Surge following that up by himself. Gets a three-man off of that, and Pixel Bob finally finishing up Jehudi.
And so crucial, he killed the Lucio before he completed the Sound Barrier. So hero plays from Moldy Serial. I guess that's part of a balanced Overwatch player's breakfast.
The Lucio-O's?
No, Moldy Serial.
Lucio-O's. Those are cereal. That's a cereal. Is it a real cereal? No, but it is in the Overwatch world.
Soon.
Soon.
Oh, man, we'll see now. They have the Sound Barrier. They're going around here flanking. This is actually pretty interesting.
Yeah. Kind of difficult to tell whose spawn is which right now. VCU do have the ultimate advantage. Concordia University working on theirs. They're so close. There we go. They've got three now, but they are going to be able to catch out Pixel Bob for a moment. But the Sound Barrier does come out, and here is that Dragon Blade. Tuna gets one. Is he going to get this next one onto Jehudi? He does. Death Blossom also comes out. Heaven Winds only able to pick up one off of that, though.
Tuna could just use his ultimate and hold down that left click button because there are so many bodies conglomerated there, just going down so fast. and another team fight over to VCU. Another delay too. Heaven Wind's going to be a few seconds behind now because Sundero was able to pick up that kill. And VCU making it from their spawn this time, coming around from the side, but they can't really poke here because if they get taken out, it's going to be a big problem. Look at this, Kevin setting up with the Death Blossom. No combo from the Nano Boost. They have no Ana, but with how they've been playing, they don't really need to.
Yeah, but they do have the Graviton Surge coming up from Moldy Serial, so he's got the high ground along with that Winston. Just waiting to see all five, trying to get that barrier low first. They are working. It's halfway there as soon as it gets to about a quarter health. There we go. He charges in, and now that's going to signal for the Reaper to move in. Kevin gets one kill off of that Death Blossom, and now he's hunting. Gets a second. He's going after this Ana. Gets put to sleep, but Bob is there. It's going to be two to the... picks up that frag onto Seah. Pandorius finally answers back, but it's not going to be enough. And right now, 95% VCU have done it. They are going to take this 2-0 victory against Concordia University Montreal.
And that has got to be one of the most emphatic victories we have seen so far. So congratulations to VCU. Curious to see what the play of the game is going to be from the squad. Tuna as Genji. That new... highlight that video intro. Ooh, look at this. Gets the reflect first and then just does so much damage on the Graviton members of Concordia University of Montreal. And really, for VCU there, there were so many plays from Pixelbob, Tuna, Sondero, like Moldy Serial. I don't know who to call the MVP of that match. The entire squad looks
It's very
fierce.
Difficult. It's very difficult. And honestly, the way that VCU were playing, it's kind of akin to the top level, like professional play, right? They were supporting their tanks well when he went in. He was getting the Zarya barriers and he was kiting out. Like, he was pretty a top level Winston at that
point. So you were wondering why they were running the Zenyatta as opposed to Ana. But the coordination they had there, like, the Zenyatta support is a little bit more consistent. Because with Ana, you know, people can block you, and you just got to keep vision if you're playing Zenyatta and have that horrible harmony. And it worked out perfectly. The way they were looping around, they were using the speed boosts to support the Winston, shielding with Zarya, have that bubble. The Genji and the Winston were targeting the same targets. It was all very well executed. It did look like a top-level team.
And, you know, unfortunately for Concordia University, they got their first loss here in the regional bracket stages, but that doesn't mean they're out, right? They're only 2-1. They just need, they still only need that one more victory to be able to secure a spot in the playoffs. So it's not over for them. So, you know, lesson learned here, VCU standout performance, and it's very difficult to, like, try and shine against a team like that. They looked really well coordinated. Individually, they looked good, and as a team, they looked fantastic.
I'm hoping we can see more of the squad in the future, honestly. If they continue to have a dominant record, we probably will. And, yeah, because obviously these aren't professional-level teams, but seriously, man, that coordination was, like, so pristine. I wonder what it looks like if you put it against another really, really good team, you know, as there's more pressure on them.
Yeah.
And considering they've already made it into the playoffs and they have done so pretty dominantly, I'm expecting we might actually see VCU in the future.
Yeah. Well, we could actually, you know, pick their brains right now. We do have Patrick Lamas on the line right now. That is going to be Moldy Serial, one of the tank players on the side of Virginia Commonwealth University. Congratulations, first off, Patrick, on your victory today. And, yeah, tell us, how did it feel, you know, in being on the stream today?
I was really nervous because yesterday I saw there was about 1,000 people. But, yeah, I think we're over it now. I was nervous.
So, generally, we saw a lot of Winston play coming out of Pixelbob. Is that something that you guys have practiced before? Because it looked really well coordinated how you guys were playing around him.
Yeah, so we set up some scrims with University of Toronto. They're playing in a couple games, but we practice a lot of Winston-Zarya combos. So we're really well coordinated. He's my duo partner, actually. So hopefully we'll get top 500.
Nice.
But yeah, we're really coordinated.
Yeah, good luck with that. Speaking of your Zarya play, there was a moment on Lizong Tower where you had a three-man Graviton Surge and then followed up on it on your own, and that basically won your team the team fight nearly entirely single-handed. What goes through your mind when you're making a play like that? Because initially, a few of your allies had died. Do you think, okay, it's time to play passive, or do you just go like, okay, guys, I can carry this team fight, let's go?
Okay, so first, if it's... if it's the very first team fight, I will just ult because I know no one else has their ult. But if it's the middle of a team, if it's like one of the next team fights, I'll ask my team, does anyone have any follow-up? But then sometimes I'll just use it.
It still works. Yeah, it was great.
Yeah.
All right, so Patrick, you said that you and Pixel Bob actually duo queue. What about the rest of your team? Do you guys queue together, or do you guys only play when you guys scrim?
We usually only play when we scrim, but sometimes we'll play Junkenstein's Revenge. Yeah. So that's about the extent.
All right. Thank you very much, Patrick. Once again, congratulations on your victory. Congratulations on securing your spot in the regional playoffs, and good luck moving forward with this tournament.
Thank you.
All right. So,
Virginia.
Yeah. Virginia representing pretty well today. Yeah, so how do you feel about that, Seamus?
I feel good. I wanted to ask him a question about, like, what do you think about UVA? But he probably would have said something mean. I was like, no, let's just keep the Virginia love on stream.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, it was a great performance coming out from them. And it sounded like, you know, he was in really high spirits there.
Yeah.
So, I mean, how can you not when you've secured your spot in the regional playoffs?
Even with what he said, you know, first we were nervous.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're not. It's cool. And that's really the best attitude, I think, to have.
Yeah, and honestly, which is why I love that we're doing this, the Collegiate Overwatch series, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're making sure that these players, they can balance their school and competitive esports and get this experience so that if they want to move forward with an esports career,
yeah,
they can say they have, like, the online tournament experience, the LAN tournament experience.
In front of a camera?
In front of a camera, and really is a completely different stage when you are playing on stream and on camera.
Yeah. For over $100,000, too, in scholarships, that's a lot of pressure on these players. So for them to perform at this level is very, very good.
Yeah, so that was our first match of the day between VCU and Concordia University. VCU with a dominant 2-0 victory, you know, starting it off 1-0 there on Hanamura, and then taking the 3-0 there on Lijiang Towers.
Mm-hmm.
But don't go anywhere, because we do have more TESPA Collegiate Series for you guys after the break. Next up, it's going to be George Mason University facing off against University at Albany.